we can connect to an SQL database in one line of Python code. That sounds very relaxing. The code looks quite simple, but when you run it, it doesn't work. So it's not as easy as it first might seem. In this video, we give you simple instructions to be able to set up your system so you can start at square one. We use an SQLite database and we need the ODBC to be able to connect the Python application to the database. We start off with our SQLite database. We can view it in a simple web window, a browser, so we can download that from the internet using this link. And that will give us the window we can use to access our SQLite database. Although it might seem strange, we're not really going to look at the SQLite database in detail at the moment. We're just going to create a new database that we're going to use to put the data inside it. Now you can see the window. We start off with the database window that will show our tables. We've got another tab for the data that we'll see that we'll create. And the last tab we might use when we're looking at the SQL. So we have our normal tabs and menus as you would expect in the system. So not too difficult to enter our test data. Now we can get our test data from any area, such as downloading it from the internet or perhaps typing it ourselves. What we want to do is we want to create our data and put it in something like a spreadsheet for now. So here's our test data of customers and food items. We move on to the ODBC and start with the installation. Here's the web page that we downloaded our SQLite ODBC. Now there's 32-bit and 64-bit. You might need one of these two, but you might not know which one yet. So I would suggest downloading both. Now the installation is quite straightforward. You can go through the setup, through the windows and download it. And then to access it, to run it, go into your control panel, go into your administrative tools, and there you'll see the data source, 32-bit, 64-bit for the ODBC. Now, click on the one that you think you'll probably use. And then we'll go into the ODBC connection. Here on this web page, we've got the details how to set up this connection on a Windows system. So these are the details if you wish to see them online. Now click on the link in your Windows and we'll go through the process. We now look at the ODBC connection. So we've already downloaded it. Now we can click on our link and we see this window. Top we have tabs. We want the first tab, and now we want the and our connection. We find the ODBC driver, click finish. Now we have to give a name. So the top field, data source name, we can put any name that we want. So you can just call it test one, for example. Now we need to link it to our SQLite database, which we put. We created a new one previously, so let's connect to that. So we open the link to that, and now you can see we have our link in the ODBC window. We can try the same with the 32-bit. You can see we might scroll down to find the ODBC driver, but again, we create a data source name and we browse to our database, the SQLite database. And perhaps it will be better for us to call this 32 so we know which one it is. But here you can see our ODBC connections, either the 32 or the 64. Now, one way we can check it is by using import and export in Access. So we've got our data in Excel and we can import it into Access. So we go to the data source in Access, go to Excel. Now we find our document that we want to import. So we're looking for our Excel documents, and in Excel we've got our customers, so we can now import that data into Access. So this is just a good way of creating backup copies of your data. So you can see in Access, we can say the first row or the column headings. We want to make sure we've got the primary key correct. So you might need to say choose your own primary key to make sure the first column is the primary key correctly. And then we're going to import it to a table. So now we have our table in Access. So we have a copy of our data from Excel imported into Access. Now, we can start to use our ODBC. So we can export this table to the ODBC database. And we're going to use the link in the machine data source. We find our name, for example, test 1, which was our link using the ODBC. And now that data that was in the Access database, we can look at our database now. So if we open our SQLite database, we will find that we have a new table in there. And in that table of customers, we have our data. So we had our data from Excel, imported it to Access, and then exported it using the ODBC connection into our SQLite database. Okay, let's do that again. We're going to find an Excel document. We're going to look for the food menu, the food items. So from Excel, we're going to import it into Access, the same as we did before. We've got our data. We've got our headings at the top, you can see, and we've already got a primary key, so we need to make sure that we stick with the same primary key, the food item ID, and then we create our table. So when we, let's call it items, we finish that, so we have our items now in our Access database, so we have a copy in Access. So now we want to export that data into our real SQLite database. Right click the table, export, find the ODBC connection, and now go to the machine data source and we can see our test connections that we created earlier on. So this one, let's try the 32 one. That seems to have worked. One way to find out is the data in the SQLite database. Let's open up our database called new, see our tables and see our data. We have our items table, our customers, and here we have the food items. If we browse the data, you can see we've got the customers as we did before, and in items you can see we've got all of our food items as well. So we didn't need to create anything in the SQLite database, we just imported it into the database using the ODBC and Access. Now let's look at our Python. We want to check to see if we're connecting to our database. So here we've got SQLite 3 and we're going to connect to our new database. We've just written some basic code to use SQL inside our Python. So we don't need to worry about this code so much. We just need to check that it works. So this is our original code. So we get customers, here's our data. So that's our test data that's in our SQLite database. Now check items. Can you remember the food items that we put in the database? Here they are. So now we've got to square one, to the start, that we can create our Python code and connect to our database. We have achieved our goal for this video. Okay, so what database have you created? If you haven't already, please subscribe. We'll let you know when the videos are being released. And if you've learned something, please click like as well.